Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com at my large all-custom Lego layout to answer a frequently asked question. How do I deal with dust? Well, the answer begins down here. Yes, at the carpet. Of course, it helps to have low pile carpeting to keep dust from accumulating in the first place, but it really doesn't help that much. The most important thing here is that you vacuum regularly, because most dust falls on the carpet, and then when you walk over it, you make it all come back up into the air, and once it's up in the air, it's floating around, and it settles down on your beautiful Lego setup. Also, don't drag your feet when you're walking around. The more you drag your feet, not only is it lazy and annoying, but that makes more dust come in the air also. However, no matter how much prevention you're involved in, you're still going to end up with dust. So, I have a toolkit for dealing with dust. These are the main things that I personally use. I've got a nice hand vacuum cleaner, and this is one that's powered by lithium batteries. They're much more powerful than the nickel-based batteries. But you can use just a regular vacuum cleaner also, because the keys here are to use small attachments, things that have small ends on them, crevice tools, and to be able to get one of these sets of all these little guys, and you get they come in a package for like 15 bucks. I got this set at Home Depot, you know, a large home improvement store, and all these things come with attachments and adapters that will work with a regular vacuum cleaner. In my case though, I used the crevice tool. I got a spare crevice tool that came with the hand vac, and then I just used some tape, some Gorilla tape, to just seal up an adapter at the end to allow me to put on another couple of the pieces that came with the miniature tool accessory kit. Now, you notice I also have a can of compressed air. This is something that I use very infrequently, because the thing about compressed air and blowing stuff off is that all that does is move the dust around. It doesn't get rid of it. So most of it's going to go into the air and end up settling somewhere again, including back on your beautiful Lego setup. So the vacuum is king. However, if you don't do it super frequently, you are going to get some dust that will settle down onto your layout that won't be able to be easily vacuumed up. And that's what these are for. Brushes. These are important. So I've got just one little small one and then one larger one. Very soft bristles and high density. You brush stuff off to release all of that trapped on dirt and dust that's getting stuck to the surface. Now, I don't ever actually brush dust off my layout with any of the brushes. I just use it to loosen up anything that might have gotten stuck on the surface. It just loosens it up. Then you come back with the vacuum. Now there you can clearly see a large area that has not been dusted recently, and there's finger marks in it from just moving around and not even noticing that it was dusty, but you can see it from this angle. First, I'm going to go over it with just the vacuum to show you what that does. Well, that doesn't look so good. The exact areas where the nozzle went, those are clean, but left all those streaks behind. Now I'm going to do it first with the brush and then with the vacuum. Wow, that's a big difference, and that's why I use a brush. The vacuuming process itself is going to take time, and unfortunately here, you cannot be lazy, you cannot take shortcuts. If you're gonna do it, you gotta do it right, and that includes moving as many things as possible. I like to do one section at a time so I don't have to move too many things out of the way and tend to forget where everything was supposed to go. Even the little stuff has to be moved out of the way though. Just free up as much space as you can. So now, look at that. All of that can be vacuumed freely with a larger tool. Use a brush, get all that stuff all loosened up. Make sure you do everywhere. I'm just going to be working on this road section here. Get into the corners and crevices of things. You can do this pretty quickly. Just make sure that you have good coverage. Think of it as brushing your teeth really quickly. Using the vacuum is like rinsing. Go easy with your vacuum itself. Make sure that you're not knocking into things and tearing things apart. That can be really frustrating, having to put things back together. So just be very careful and cautious. Make sure that you also manage your hose if you're using a regular floor-based, you know, stand-up vacuum cleaner with an attachment adapter at the end or something large. I like to start with, you know, larger tools to begin with and then move down to smaller stuff. Make sure that you look for where your hose is going, because that can be in areas that can be tearing stuff apart as well. The little stuff needs dusting too, and that's why I have the small little brush just to get in there, loosen the stuff up again. You can even just kind of come down on the top. It just needs enough direct pressure from something directly on it physically to loosen that stuff up, and then it can all be vacuumed. Also, be sure to not scratch the surface with whatever tool that you're using on your vacuuming system. For large stuff, I like to use tools that have a little brush on the end, and then I leave the thing just over the surface. I don't actually touch the surface beneath with the end of the tool, because that could scratch it a little bit. I just brush over the top, kind of using the brush as a depth gauge so I never go too far. Keeping a Lego layout nice and clean takes time and it takes work. So you do need to have some patience. And if you have a large area or a lot of little things, what I like to do is just break up the work. Don't try to take it on all at one time, because then you'll procrastinate and say, you know, I'll do it tomorrow. I'll do it next week. And the dust will just build up and build up and build up. So instead of saying, okay, today is gonna be the day I'm gonna do it all, just say, today I'm gonna dust this block, and just do one block. The next day, do another. Maybe you'll skip one day because you've got something else you'd rather do. But you know, just keep doing it little chunk by little chunk on a regular basis, stay on top of it, and you'll stay nice and clean and beautiful like this, and you'll be really happy with it. That's how I deal with dust. I hope that was a useful video for you, and I hope that you'll come back for more. Talk to you again soon.